Hey, good morning. How are you? I am on here because I'm going to start showing my hairstyle. My friend Monique Maxie is always talking about how I change my hair, which I do. I change my hair a lot. But what you're going to learn about me, I am the person who has all of these bags of hair and that I create stuff out of nothing. And I'll see somebody's hair and I'll want to copy that. So in a year's time, I might spend $50 to $75 on hair for the whole year. Because everything I have, I reuse, I wash, I condition. I do it like it is my hair. But I've had several people who wanted to talk to me about my hair. So this hairstyle right here is inspired by my friend Tanya Cooper. The only thing that's different between mine and Tanya's hair is the color. And Tanya's is real. Her hair is beautiful. Their whole family, all the girls have beautiful, beautiful hair. But this is a weave that and listen, another thing. I sew mine in. I may have three hairstyles in a week. Three. But I sew them in. I don't glue them in and I don't use wigs. I need to invest in some wigs. I'm going to try to. But I never wear my hair straight. Never. And don't get me wrong, I've had hair. Listen, don't come for me. Like, she's always been bald headed. No. I cut my hair off. But yeah, this hairstyle right here is inspired by my friend, good friend Tanya Cooper. We've been friends. I've been friends with all of them for years. We were like kids and we're still good friends. I wanted to give a shout out to some people. Sheila and Fred Fagg, my parents, love these people. I'm in the process of releasing this book. I have until the 15th of February. But it is going wonderful. It's taken me 6 years to do the book. It's called You Spare My Life. And it has some very, very interesting things in it. This book is going to inspire people. I don't give out a lot of names, so don't ask. But I have to tell my story because there's somebody out there that has been through this and don't know how to deal with it. So in my story, I'm hoping I'm going to be blessing people to be able to speak up and be free from past pains and stuff like that. Let's see. My friend Lori. Crazy girl. Look her up on Facebook. Lori Faith, I think it's what she's under on Facebook. I love you, Lori. Andrea Berry, my little sister. She is an amazing person. She's been through a lot and God is really blessing her. So I want to give a shout out to her. I just want to shout out some people because I'm thankful that God has brought positive people in my life, people that have been there for me, people that who have had my back through some rough times. My daughters, Arshia, Larissa, and Kia, thank you. Thank you for just being my children. I'm glad God gave them to me because those babies, first of all, they're beautiful. Yes, you can shout out to your own kids. They're beautiful because they are. But I'm thankful for them for having my back. Anyway, back about the book. The book will, it will bless you. I was writing on Saturday and I was talking it over with my friend Lori and I got so emotional and so, God just poured into me so much stuff that I just had to pour it out on paper and it's like I couldn't type fast enough. No, I don't type well anyway. but still, it was just a blessing how he's just blessing me to be able to write this book and even begin to think about the next book and what the title is going to be. But look for it soon. I keep saying that, but I'm telling y'all, it's coming for real, for real. It's getting so exciting to see it come all to the end of 6 years ago when I started. Well, I started way before the end. But the fact that 6 years ago is when I got serious about it. And then watching it transpire into where it is now, it is so, so, so amazing. I'm so thankful to God that he's given me the ability to have a platform to talk to people. And my platform, what I mean by that is just being here, being wherever I can speak and talk about my life and how God has blessed me from then to now and where I am and the struggles that I've had and the things I've had to deal with and things that not so pretty things and how God has blessed me into being to where I am right now. But yeah, look for it. It is so exciting. So exciting. So it will be, wait, one more thing. My friend Susan, I did a video with her. Look down at the videos. My friend Susan, she's the one who's editing my book. She is amazing. She is, she and I are partners in crime for real, but don't tell nobody. But this book is going to be amazing. So today I say to you, God bless you. Have a great day. And I'm getting ready to post some pictures of some hairstyles. It's like the many faces of Rosalind Friend is what I'm going to call it. Because I change my hair so much. I change color. I love color. I don't care if anybody you don't like the color. I don't care if you don't like the color pink. I don't care if you don't like the color purple. It doesn't matter. This is my head. And this is what I like to do with my head. This is the first time I've been black. But you see that little bit of pieces of color in it? I had to put just a little bit of color in it. I couldn't do all black. But yeah, I'm getting ready to post a video soon. So, I'm trying to figure out if I should do it today. Yeah, I think I'm going to try to do it today. Post the many hairstyles of Rosalind Friend. How about that? What y'all think? Y'all like this one? No, it's not a wig. Yes, I sewed it in. I braid my hair. My friend Monique Maxie talks about me all the time. She said I need help. But I will change my hair. Like right now, I have a hairstyle in my head that I have to do. I know I'm not even going to tell you what it is, but I'm going to be changing this. This will be today and tomorrow. I wore it yesterday. I will take it out. I used to try to do my hair on Saturdays and do it again on Tuesday or even Wednesday. But, you know, it relaxes me. The change. I love change. Some people don't like change. I'm good with change. I am. I'm good with change. But again, look forward to talking to you guys. Please hit me up. Subscribe. Like and share this video. Do something for me today. If you're my friend, and if you love me, if you respect who I am, speak well over somebody's life today. Talk to them and let them know. Just give them a smile. Let them know today they may be going through something, but just know that they have somebody that's in their corner. Just talk, speak well of somebody today. All this negativity and all this disrespect, it's not even worth it. It's not. So, God bless you. Have a great day. Hope you guys had a good Sunday. I went to church. Yes, I am looking for a church home. I went to church yesterday. Love to hear the man of God preach. He's a powerful house. He really is. But I'm still in search for a new church home. What I'm getting out of searching and going to different churches is God is showing me church love. You have a lot of folks in church that don't show love, but God is showing me church love. I don't know if it's because it's the first time they see me or if they want me to come or what it is, but it's church love. It's amazing. It's amazing to be loved by church people and you know that they're real. That's what that is. But yes, so please keep me in prayer for that I find a home church. And I'm a church girl. I don't like not being in church. I have struggled since September trying to find a place to worship. I'm in a city where there's many, many, many churches, but I don't want to just go to anyone. I want to be able to go where I'm comfortable. I want to go where I can hear the word of God. I want to be able to, not just the music. And I don't want to sing, believe it or not. I just want to sit still for a little bit. I did that before. I was at a church for almost a year before I even sang a word. A lot of people didn't even know I sang. So it's not about that for me. I know my gift. I know what I'm capable of doing. But I want to be able to hear the word. I want them to dissect the word for me so I can really get what God has for me. Thank you so much. I hear my grandson trying to come here, so I'm trying to cut this off. But keep me in prayer. I love you guys. Have a great day. Share this video. Inspire somebody to be the best that they can be. be the best that they can be. Any negativity, get it away from you. You don't need it. Pray blessings over top of you. I pray blessings that God, you can hear God, you can see God, and you can remember the word of God that Jesus loves you. God bless you. Have a great day. Today's Monday. Start this week off. Start doing something for you. Every day, do something for you. Every day. God bless you. Bye.